hope you guys enjoyed that introduction, by the way. It does wonders for your speed reading. So, what better way to celebrate the 4th than with some chess? And what better way to play some chess than to play a favorite, at least a fan favorite. So, yeah, it's necessary to let the music roll. I can't just interrupt John Williams. Say what you will about him stealing from Gustav Holst. Arguably, Holst wasn't that popular anyway. I'm sure over time people would grow to appreciate Holst. But my own appreciation of Holst is through Williams. If not for Williams, people would hear Holst and think, what in the world is this? Although Holst is pretty cool. Here you hear the allusion to Mars, where you got this 5-4 meter. 5-4 meaning there's 5 beats to every measure, and the beat is the quarter note. And we just assume that the quarter note's the beat here, because there's, I don't know, that's pretty traditional for relatively fast-moving pieces of music, that the quarter note gets the beat. Anyhow, let me not bore you with music theory, and let me bore you with chess moves instead. Oh, come on, move it, R2, move it! Also, if anybody knows a way that I can upscale this game, let me know. I'd be glad to do that. I should have done the King's Gambit. Now we got a long and challenging battle ahead. Since Kasparov's been doing the Scotch lately, let's try the Scotch. You see in the lower right corner, this opening is labeled Scotch Game. Which is pretty cool that this game even bothered to put in opening labels. Ooh, this stormtrooper's gonna get it. Would not want to mess with Chewie. That's for sure. It's a Scotch Game for ... N. Ooh. We don't have just any Scotch. We've got the line that Kasparov made popular, so watch me mess it up somehow. I think this is theory. I think you're supposed to defend the pawn. And if black counters with bishop b4, I think there's some resource here. Though I'm forgetting what. Maybe it's just queen d3. Yeah, I don't remember. Maybe it's knight b5. Is this the line where white goes completely crazy and plays knight b5? There's one way to find out, isn't there? Alright, Wookiee. Don't let me down. I have a feeling that this is like the sharpest line in the Scotch Gambit. Or Scotch game. We'll have to check this out afterward and see how I did. That can't be good. Okay, so is this the part where I play like Bishop E2 or something? Or Bishop E3? I don't know. I just can't believe that. I don't know. Bishop E2, Queen takes G2, Bishop F3 seems fun. We've got to find out where this leads. Probably somewhere where I don't want to go, but we'll see. How cool would it be if you could influence the outcome of these battles? Ouch. How cool would that be, though? Alright, Bulba. Here we go. Done in by a lowly R2. It's pretty hard to imagine that happening to Boba Fett. Oh! So we're defending C7 now, are we? Okay. I wonder why he's defending C7 with the king. It seems a little awkward. Then again, my knight on B5 is nothing special either. At some point, I should probably figure out, am I playing against the most difficult level, or do I have a chance? Well, I'm gonna say it now, the Rebel Alliance is kinda doomed. Unless I get some help. Pretty sure the Alliance is doomed at this point. Let's pin, that is a knight, right? Yeah, I think that's like a Gungan or something. Let's pin that down. Doo-doo! Well, that was dramatic. I think I'm okay, though. I mean, yeah, this is a pretty awkward-looking position again. And I'll probably use that word and overuse it. But, I don't know, I think I'm doing okay. There's gonna be a lot of blood spilled soon, though. Like, a lot of blood. Assuming there is blood in the Star Wars universe, maybe there isn't. Hadn't thought much about that. So I'm trying to prepare to sack on D6. Meanwhile, Black is doing these annoying moves that force me to advance my pieces in somewhat strange. Uh-oh! I did not see that. Yeah, and I just gambited a knight. That can't be good. I mean, I was going to sack that knight on d6, and now I'm just down a knight. I hate to do a take back, but... yeah, I need to do another take back. And we're going to go back this way and pretend I didn't hang the piece. None of you saw that. Alright, so I've been building up to try to sack on d6 for a couple turns now. I'm tempted to play bishop f4, knight e4, bishop takes queen, knight takes, bishop takes g7. Or, if my opponent just moves their queen out of the way, I can just sack on d6. Well, here's my opportunity to do a bold, dramatic sacrifice. It's not a particularly good sacrifice. I could also move my Yoda to attack his Vader. Then we might see Vader f8 or Vader d7. Or we might see Boba Fett e6. I should just activate my other Yoda. Get a move on it, Yoda. Any day now. Just keep Yoda-ing along. Hey, welcome. Alright. So, I'm not sure what the point of that move is. I mean, it hits this R2, that R2, and it hits Leia. But I can move Leia to fork these two dudes and attack this dude. But then we get Boba to E6. Okay, so... what if I just move my Leia here? Or back here? This is awkward. Yeah, this is just normal chess with slightly different looking pieces. I think I want to just move my Leia forward. Because she covers everything. I predict this Boba is going to move soon. Oh. I see. Well, and that damn Gungan defends the stormtrooper. That's annoying. Well, we're gonna go back and pretend everything's okay, even though really it isn't. Oh wow, that was fast. Did I blunder? No. No, computer's just developing its pieces. So, where do I develop? Do I move my R2 to hit a stormtrooper over here? I think that weakens my Luke side, though. I'm curious, why do you ask? I have not ever streamed a Wii U game on this, because I'm not sure how you'd hook up such a thing to a computer and be able to stream any of that anyhow. Well, whoops. Yeah, no. You're moving here, I suppose. I'm chickening out, not sacking my Chewie. Instead of sacking him for the stormtrooper there, I'm just gonna run back. And this does liquidate pieces, but I didn't see anything better. Ooh, 480p. That sounds painful. I do have some kind of video capture device for my N64. I haven't had very much success with attaching that with my computer and my monitor and all that. I'll have to figure that out sometime, I guess.
Oh dear.
That's rather uncivilized. Oh, crap. I must be playing against a good level. Because now I see Boba takes R2, and it forks my Yodas. To illustrate the point, we'll do R2 takes Gungan, and we'll get to see this combination on the board. Maybe he'll miss it. Maybe he'll mouse slip. Well, this isn't going so well. I must have picked a pretty difficult skill level of an opponent. There's only one option remaining. We're gonna turn to the dark side. Apparently, it didn't even give me time to flip the board. It just moved. That's okay. Let's see, can we flip the board? Alright, where's the flip board thing? Can I just hit F to flip board, or Control F, or something? Game menu. Settings menu. Play menu. Look and feel menu. Ah, there we go. White on top. There we go. Okay, that's just a little bit challenging, but somehow I'll make do. Yeah, that's just a little bit challenging. Oh! Oh, wait. So this is an exchange of two Yodas for a Vader. Oh. I didn't even see that possibility. I suppose I played Boba takes Yoda. Yoda takes Vader. AT takes Yoda. Looks okay, but also looks pretty loose. I don't see anything better, though, so we're gonna go with it. Ooh, that's gotta hurt. That's the only circumstance under which Yoda would lose a fight anyhow. You know, maybe Yoda will just stumble and fall before he makes his way over to Vader. We can hope. We can dream. No, but realistically, it's too much to hope for. Yeah. Any day now, Yoda. Come on. You can do it. Anytime now. And he walks right through Vader. Brilliant. What? What's this? Oh, okay. Apparently Yoda's a Super Saiyan or something. There's a remarkable lack of bloodshed in these games. It's actually kind of nice. Yeah, so Leia... Oh! To the back? That takes the pawn with tempo. Or the stormtrooper. You know, this dark side thing isn't working out very well. So, yeah. Huh. Oh, Cleedocly? You know, this is going to be a long and difficult endgame if I don't do something really cheap here. Oh no, I touched my Palpatine. I have to move it. Also, this way we get to see a new animation. And I'm talking about the combat that occurs here. Huh. And that's how Leia would beat an AT unit. But we're going to put white back on bottom. And we're going to say, you know what? Being the dark side just isn't for us. You know that AT you just lost? Or AT-AT? Yeah. I'll be taking advantage of that. Oh, what the? Are you serious? How is that even possible here? Are you serious? So that Boba's gonna result in the dark side taking my C-3PO. Gotta be kidding me. This game is difficult. I thought Black was busted here for sure. And now I'm finding out that, okay, it's still probably technically a lost endgame, but this is way more difficult than I envisioned. What do I do? I mean, if I move Luke, then the AT-AT takes my C-3PO. I don't see any way to tactically benefit from that. What a mess. So, in normal parlance, King h2, rook takes f1, queen takes b7, bishop d3, queen d5, bishop somewhere, and then queen takes f7. And I'm ahead, but... oh, what a mess. We've got to try it, though. Can I help test your little web app? If it works on my mobile device, then I could maybe help with that. My chat window and my computer are on separate devices, so it'd be a little tricky for me to test this on my computer. So I did not see this. I did not foresee this. What's the point? I mean, obviously, I can move Leia back here. The AT-AT unit moves away, and something happens. I'm not even sure where it moves. Maybe back to F1. But Leia's misplaced all the way over here. Could move Leia to d5, hitting this pawn. This is a very resourceful move. Yeah, I don't know how to win this endgame. We've got Leia, they've got an AT-AT, and a Boba Fett. That's pretty balanced. Well, at least generally speaking. Maybe if I take here, they take there. No, these run quickly. Alright, is this indirectly defended somehow? Not that I see. Oh my. This is a very difficult endgame. I'm not sure how to play this one. It's really easy to make targets, and really difficult to defend targets. Can move Leia back. We'll probably see Boba go back. Oh wait, no. If I go back, then Boba takes here. And defends that. It's just a case of perfect timing. Ooh, jeez. Yeah, no, really. He would basically need a chess AI to play this endgame. It's super complicated. I think I have to play something slow and defensive. Something that defends A2, F2, and C3. Normally, against like a human player, I'd be tempted to just snap a7 and say, you know what, you can play whatever you feel like playing, I'm going to beat you and just grind you down. I'm not so confident against a computer that I'd be able to pull that off. So I think I have to go back and defend everything. Now, I think back here is a better way to defend things. It's at least more efficient. So let's try that. And then I have to push these guys on the king's side so they aren't as endangered. And just to give my king a little space. Yeah, the AT is a rook. And Bulba here is a bishop. So we've got a very difficult endgame on our hands. So I could do Leia D4. Threatening Leia G7. Taking those dudes out. Could do Leia A5. Not entirely sure what the point of that would be. That it attacks A7 and F5. Oh wait, no, F5's defended. That's kind of super annoying. So I'll put this on a light square. And hopefully be okay. So computer offers an exchange of A7 for C3, which I don't think is a fair exchange because it's got too many pawns running in the center. Actually, material's completely level here, despite my trickery trying switching between the dark side and the light side of the force. Apparently, even such trickery can't get me any advantage. Yeah, material's completely level. That's what's frustrating me here. It's not that I'm playing poorly, it's that there is no win. So there's got to be somewhere safe Bulba moves to. Potentially F1. And so now Black's big threat is to play AT to C2, or AT to C2, and then I have to do Luke G1. Oh. It's got Bulba takes on G2. Oh, well, I have to attempt to force a draw here now. Because I sure as heck am not winning this. Jeez, how did this... how's this happening here? If I go there... I mean, okay, I could keep this AT off the second rank, so that's probably what I need to do. And just chase it around and declare that this is a draw. Yeah, what the heck, I might be able to give you some help with that, testing that. Sure, why not? Okay. I just have perpetual pursuit here. Although here I'm actually attacking the Stormtrooper on F5, so I might profit somehow from this. Oh, what's this? A new development. Okay. Well, that seems risky, because I just go to C1 and then take G5. I'm no computer myself, but I see this tactic. It's not that hard to spot. What malicious thing does Black have in store? Yeah, I could harass Boba, I guess. I didn't think about that. Well, no, that was only possible once the AT-AT unit moved off the first rank. And then I was able to harass Boba. But now I can just take G5. How did the computer miss this? Well, we're gonna find out, guys. Just assume, as Leia finishes walking over there, take your time. It's not like we're paid hourly here. Not like we're paying hourly, is the saying. Alright, so now I just go back to C1 and everything's fine. That was a really weird exchange. Also, I could go to G7 to D4 to B4. Just check, and then back to D4, and then over to B4, and harass the unit there. It's really difficult to find a reason not to do that, so we're gonna do it. I don't feel like exchanging A3 for anything on the king's side, so we're gonna go this way. Yeah, no, killing that stormtrooper on F5 might cost me a piece. So we're gonna go this way instead. Take your time. Any day now. I'm sure for the 90s this must have been awesome, though. Alright, so now I could go to B4 if I wanted to. I think I still do. I mean, what's the worst that could happen if I go there? I could also interpolate Leia C4 if I wanted Palpatine to move this way, but I don't think I do. Plus, that doesn't force anything, necessarily. Hear that? I used the word force. Okay. Yeah, no, Boba moves diagonally. So are we going to C5? No, we're going to B5. Okay, we can do that. That seems a bit exciting. I'm curious if it's going to block my check, or if Palpatine's going to move. Alright, yeah, no, this makes sense. Just block the check. Okay. I'm just curious what's going to happen if I go this way. Oh, Perry, you sound surprised. I mean, what did you expect? Star Wars backgammon? No, we're doing Star Wars chess. You missed earlier, I tried to be all sneaky and tricky and switch sides to the dark side. And after having switched to the dark side and thinking I was winning material, it didn't actually work out. So then I tried to sack a rook and switch back to the light side of the force, and, you know, I'm still not winning this. It's actually kind of sad. Alright, we're going to just run the A pawn and see what happens. Alright, we're going to try clicking on this. Yeah, I'm not surprised. I don't really trust the name of that application thing. Also, I'm not surprised of what it's called. But, yeah, apparently it didn't cause any damage on my computer, if that's what you were hoping for. Wait, can I not just... Am I looking at this wrong? What square is... Oh, that's on D6. That's not on D7. Okay, well, we're just going to keep running. Right? Or do I go check here and then check there and then... Yeah, this is confusing. If I check here, Palpatine just goes forward. Yeah, no, that tactically isn't justified, so I just need to keep going. Yeah, you see, there's a reason I have Nightbot in the channel. It's to try to protect people against that sort of thing. It's kind of clever, though. So I could check here. Oh, and then he blocks the stormtrooper. I can't even take this stormtrooper because Boba defends him. Where's my Leia standing? Okay, Leia's standing on A7. I wasn't entirely sure because R2 is blocking part of the view. Alright. So here my clever plan of pushing the pawn comes to fruition. And note how conveniently Palpatine gets in the way of Boba Fett. Oh, what? Guys! I have a choice between two good moves here. I'm thinking, yeah, now here we go. Right? Am I missing something? Here we go. May the Fourth be with you. Uh-oh. Ooh, that could hurt. Well, it's a good thing Leia won that battle. Although, this isn't gonna go so well for Leia. Ouch. Again, no bloodshed. I think that's a positive of this whole Star Wars series. Oh, I didn't even get to choose which piece to promote to. Alright, so we gotta stop this runaway stormtrooper. Any day now, just stop hiding in the corner and fight your damn war already. So then we cut this off. Ok Conveniently, I control all the dark squares. You'd think that the dark side would have better control of the dark squares, but apparently not. Get used to hearing some of these themes. Can I offer my opponent the chance to resign? Because now would be kind of an appropriate time for the opponent to resign this. Just saying. Alright, do I have any pieces trapped? Or rather, have I trapped Boba? Boba's pretty darn close to being trapped here. What happens if I go here? Palpatine's making a run for it. Alright. We'll see how far you go, Palpatine. I'm actually trying to bait that stormtrooper to move forward. Reason for that is that I can just get to improve the placement of my pieces. Darn shame I don't have a forced mate here. I can do Leia D5, Palpatine somewhere, Luke somewhere, but it's not so impressive. Hang on. Yeah, we're gonna step back here for a moment. Completely separate Palpatine from his army. And yeah, we're just gonna go try to mate. Oh no! He's gonna promote! Oh my goodness! I didn't see that coming. Okay, here we go. Yeah. Well, that's fine. A little more advanced notice of what it was would kind of be appreciated. It's a shame it doesn't work on your hardware, though. Yeah, you're right. I should have just done queen takes on F5. No need to go through all this mess. As long as I don't misclick and move Luke to D5, I'm okay. It'd be kind of a shame if I accidentally move to D5 and then I'm losing everything. Now, assuming it's greedy and doesn't sack a stormtrooper, we're just going to go after Palpatine. I would have gotten away with it too, if not for you meddling kids. Alright, so... Thank you. trying to force them to move the stormtrooper forward. Okay, we're just gonna take the stormtrooper and be happy. I don't need an extra queen to win this. However, I do need to capture those damn stormtroopers that keep threatening to promote. Because one Darth Vader is enough. Your king is in... Oh, I can't move Luke because he's actually in D7 rather than D8. Right. I was questioning what piece could possibly be checking Luke here. But yeah, now this is pretty straightforward. Alright, back! Back to the back rank with you. So, now I've committed Palpatine to the back rank. Should be able to engineer some kind of checkmate here. Luke E5, Luke F6 seems pretty strong. Or just E6 and then F6. Huh. Would you look at that? Thinks he can stop me. I mean, it could certainly slow me down. Look at that stormtrooper go. He's on a mission. Do, do, do. All right, here we go. Totally worth it. But if anybody knows how to boost the resolution on this old PC game, let me know. Jeez. That little MIDI chiptune needs some help. Yeah. Alright, the Rebels win. I don't even get the animation of, like, KOing Palpatine. It's just, you win. Good for you. Alright. Here, let's just get a new game. And let the computer play it out. Oh, did I not pick... select players, computer versus computer. There we go. So now we get to see, is it really easier being the dark side? I mean, it's a path of least resistance, but is it any easier or better being the dark side? Time will tell. I mean, yeah, it would probably look awful upscaled. It's just, why not try it if there is any way? But it'd probably look awful. Yeah, maybe there's some way in OBS I could just manipulate this all. Let's see how it looks. I've seen it. Looks on OBS. Look, it looks on my screen where it's full screened and unfortunately not at double resolution or anything. Yeah. It's the double Wookiee attack. Little known double Wookiee attack. think it gives you ECO codes and opening names and such if you don't have the cursor on top of where it would normally show that. Anyhow, it seems we've transposed in some kind of almost a Queen's Gambit declined. Except White's forgotten to play c4. Well, the thing is, now the application is consuming, it is a 720p application at this point. It's just that the graphics only consume the center part of the application. I really need to just restart the app, have it be in its normal window size, and then have OBS do all the scaling and try instead of having the app try to scale things. I don't know, this opening has some good surprise value. It's about its only merit. Since otherwise, Black is kind of doing better here. I mean, you could play c5 and tarash it up. Yeah, there is that, but then you have Wookiee a3. Is he gonna go left or right? Left or right? Oh, he goes to the right. Yeah, that's not so good. Now the dark side's just doing better. So, who's predicting a dark side victory? Other than me. Alright, so isn't there Wookiee A4 here though? Okay, maybe you just play R2 to B3 first. But oh, it just seems like a really weird time to move your Vader out. Yeah. I called it. We got Wookiee A4. And this is just awkward. I mean, yeah, A4 is not the best square for a Wookiee, but yeah, he really hasn't lost much time there. Oh, are you serious? He's not going to even play C4 first? Oh, he's just taking C5. No. He's... That's such a computer move. Alright, A6? Yeah. Play A6 and B5 and get the queen side rolling. Understandably, White wants to capture and resolve some of the tension. But this is just ugly for White. Also, Stormtrooper's not exactly the best aim ever. In case nobody's noticed that yet. Just kicks him right off the board. I assume that having chess games that just do computer versus computer is fairly uncommon, at least in terms of like video game ish chess experiences. Yeah, look at those stormtroopers roll. They completely dominate the center. And the light side optimistically hopes for some kind of attack on the toward Palpatine on the Luke side. And with that, dark side is completed development. Notice how the AT-ATs are connected, meaning that all the other pieces are off the back rank and ready to fight. And even the ATs themselves are starting to mobilize. Yeah, I prefer the dark side here, but I don't know. It might not be enough to win. Oh, what's that? Why would you do that? Is E4 really that weak? You can't seriously be considering taking E4. So what's the point? Oh, really? Look at that smug retreat.
Oh! Oh dear!
You might speak tons of languages, but you can't deal with that kind of threat. Ooh, look at that backward pawn. Well, I guess it used to be backward, and it's still backward. It is protecting the E4 square. So, this position's kind of closing up. Minus the C-file. The C-file could be huge, but it's going to take a long time to develop. Oh, that's really clever. I half expected R2 to move to C1, though, to hit Boba Fett. But, no, White's just optimistically going all out for the attack. That's pretty sharp. Yeah, so now Dark Side controls C1. And the Light Side's chickening out again. There's only so far you can retreat before you get overwhelmed. It's not going to be easy for the light side. Yeah, a lot of these computer moves don't make much sense. Especially the ones that White's making. So are we going to see that move to C2? No. Alright, we're protecting E5, though I'm not sure why, because it's already protected. Oh, I guess, yeah, if you'd gone back to C2, then this would just kick the AT off of C2. Could go to the second rank, but would probably get trapped. Yeah, so it's a good positional move there, just advancing slowly on the king's side. What kind of crap move is Leia to F1? You can't be serious. I mean, if you're stuck playing moves like that, your position's pretty dire. Okay. So we see an exchange of rooks. And an exchange of bishops. And I don't understand this in the slightest. It seems like a really poor exchange for Black. Because he's losing his best bishop. Yeah, no, this is just completely equal. If not better for White now. Because the dark side has a dark squared bishop, which is just going to run into its pawns all day. So, yeah. Not a good day to be the dark side. Yeah, I don't understand what either player's been doing the last few moves. White's been playing really passively the entire game, but Black had a really incredibly promising position until a couple moves ago where he decides he wants to trade off the bishops and the rooks and stuff. Now it's just a really meh position. There just really isn't a whole lot to hope for here. I don't understand why Black went for any of this. F4. Really? No, F3. Okay. I was going to say, F4 seems a bit crazy here. Like, can't we finish one thing before we start the next? Oh, look at me. I'm going back to A3 here. Okay, now he takes on C5, I suppose? Yeah. The obvious forced move happens.
Don't shoot.
Yeah. If you watch any of C-3PO's animations where he kills things, it's all accidental. And yet, whenever he fights in a battle, he just gets crushed. Anytime he doesn't win. Just bam!
It's very irregular. We're doomed.
We're doomed! Yeah, he just puts up no resistance whatsoever. And whenever he does win a battle, it's just because he's a klutz. Alright, so you're going to C1, I suppose? Threatening some kind of discovery thing, maybe? Although you can't move the Wookiee because it's pinned. There aren't enough pieces defending Yoda. I mean, if you could get your other Wookiee to E2, you might be able to do some discovery, but... No! Oh my goodness, what are you doing? If that doesn't win a pawn outright, then don't do it. Yeah, Vader to C3 just looked so much stronger. Okay, and F4 is just retarded. Because both it gives up the A pawn, and it allows exchanges in the center, which activate the Gungan on F6, so... Oh, I'm sorry, that's a knight on F6, a bishop on E6. Oh, I've completely misassessed this position. Yeah, now that Boba Fett on E6 was really strong this whole time. I somehow thought it was a dark-squared bishop, but no, it's definitely a light-squared bishop. Okay, so that completely changes the assessment. I got the knight and the bishop confused. In which case, yeah, White's just been under pretty serious fire for the last series of moves. Yeah, it's just struggling to hold things together. Not unlike Episode 4, where the Rebel fleet are just not in a very good position to start with, for sure. Alright, so what's the point of this deck? Oh, right. The Wookiee's not a bishop, it's a knight. So now we've pinned the Wookiee twice. Oh, that's a clever little exchange. Now Black can select to exchange rooks or to exchange queens. Personally, I'd go for the queen trade, because that kind of position is a lot easier for a human to play. Just exchange the queens and... I don't know. I mean, yes, your queen on the second rank as it stands now is pretty strong.
but I don't know.
I don't think that having queens on the open board means many checkmate chances. And in particular, it's not clear where Vader's going here. Maybe Vader's going to A4 or A5, both of which are pretty defensive moves. So, yeah, Black's gonna run away majority on the queen side, but it's not so clear whether Palpatine's gonna be safe. Again, like episode 4, where Darkseid has this crushing advantage, and it's only a matter of time before they win. Unless the light side manages to craft something really clever here and somehow break through the weak point in the dark side's defenses. So yeah, here we go. Forward we advance, and hopefully we get a perpetual check. Otherwise, the dark side takes the point. Yeah, I'm curious if that engine wants to balance out the result from last game. Or if it just wants this to be a dramatic game. But most computer games end in draws, because it's uncommon for the computer to miss something that it would see. So if a tactic or an idea is missed for one color, it's generally missed for both. Yep, so that's a free pawn. And the dark side can't take the Wookiee, because then Palpatine's cover is blown. So as long as Palpatine moves, there might not be a perpetual check. This is where it gets a little bit fuzzy. I don't think that there's a perpetual check, but sure as heck is not a comfortable position. Although, look at that. The Wookiee on C6 is hanging. So, whoa. Why are we not taking C6? Am I forgetting how the pieces move? Why would you opt for this when you could just take the Wookiee on C6? Is there, like, some crazy, crazy perpetual that happens if you do take? Or is there some tactic with, like, Queen G5? I just don't get it. Didn't make any sense to me. Actually, no, Queen G5 is pretty strong. So, I guess this is the point. So you could defend with the Gungan on H5 defending G7. There's no checkmate on G7. Otherwise, the Stormtrooper would have to move to G6, and then Queen H6, Queen G7 mate. Still, this looks anything but safe. Wow. Alright, so now you take out D4. What's the deal here? We're gonna secure the king by pushing all the pawns that defend it. Meanwhile, we're going to finally offer a queen trade. And yeah, no, the dark side's gonna take the point. There's no way whatsoever that the rebel fleet are gonna come back from this. And I say that because there's two stormtroopers advancing on the queen side. And there's just no stopping them. Yeah. With Leia goes the hope of the entire rebel fleet. Tough break. And the engine's not willing to accept it, but no, the dark side's gonna win this. Yeah, just step out of silly tactics, let the stormtrooper go, and light side's just way too slow to pull off anything constructive. This is so over. Assuming the computer has any technique whatsoever, and I'd like to assume that at least in an endgame, it's gotta play decently. Alright, so you advance the R2 to defend the Wookiee, and I guess that bears some threats. Black's trying to re-centralize his pieces. Yeah, actually in endgames, it's really tempting to move the pawns too quickly. Even in pawn races, moving pawns is dangerous. You want to make sure your pieces are placed okay or decently or actively before you start running the pawns. Because pieces are the things that generate most of the threats. And only once you've got some secure footing, then do you start advancing your pawns. Because they move slower than you would imagine. So you have to really prepare their advance well. So here, note that the knight and the bishop are both on light squares. This generates a wall that cannot be penetrated by the king. Alright. Wait, what's this? Oh, okay, I misjudged where that was landing. If that were landing on E3, then I have to really question what's the point of the fork. But no. I would not trade here. I'm not a computer, but yeah, no, trading doesn't seem valuable at all. Alright, is he gonna go left or right? Left or right? Probably left. Shows what I know. Yeah, but now you... I'm not sure where you go. Oh! That's clever. That keeps control on the diagonal, trying to keep the king away, while at the same time bearing pressure on G2. Alright, so that's threatening to go to... Well, it can't go to C3. Because it just gets taken on C3. It could go to D2 and then to B3. It's a possibility. Now, here the computer is giving up some kind of hope. I mean, that's really a long-term optimism there if you're pushing the pawn to G3. Because this... It's on the verge of promotion, and in order to stop the stormtrooper on the A-file, you have to put your Wookiee on A1. And sure, it's difficult for the dark side to harass the Wookiee on A1, but... yeah. if it's going to take a long time for that a stormtrooper to promote, but it's going to happen. What complicates the promotion is that Black does not have a dark squared bishop. So yeah, Black does have enough material to win this. And he's even forced the Wookiee to go to A1. Oh, okay, well, he's going to defend the Wookiee with the other Wookiee. Yeah, I don't actually understand what Black's doing here. Because you don't want to trade off your bishop here. Yeah. It's going to be a slow, painful maneuvering game. But I'm pretty sure Black can still win this. So there's a threatened fork on E5, picking off the Boba Fett. Yeah, Palpatine's not falling for any of that nonsense. So Palpatine's got to make his way all the way across the board. And, yeah. The light side are going to be kind of jerks about it and force him to take the long route via the A file. He's not going to be able to march directly through the center. So Palpatine's going to have to go the long route. I mean, yeah, he's going to attempt to walk through the center, but I don't think he's going to be able to move that way. Okay, so now he's actually decoyed Luke over to the Queen's side. Meaning that Palpatine could go munch up the pawns on the king's side. I mean, the light side can make all their potshot threats and such, and be annoying and a nuisance, but as the light side are wont to do throughout the series. But, yeah, no, this is pretty much over. Because I have confidence that Darkseid won't mess this up. Note that the point of this maneuver is that Palpatine makes his way to G4, whereas if he had tried to directly approach G4, then you would have seen Wookiee H2. Well, now there's no time for Wookiee H2. Alright, so because the one Wookiee moved... Actually, this is the other reason there was no time for Wookiee H2 earlier. It's that the other Wookiee on B3 would have been on pre. So now we see Luke C1. I'm not so confident about... Well, that's terrible. You don't play that. I was going to say, I'm not so confident about this Stormtrooper to B3 advance. Ooh, it's check. Yeah, I wasn't so confident about the Stormtrooper advancing to B3, though, because that gives up the C3 square. And yes, it does threaten to move to B2, but if the pawns all get liquidated, this is going to be... Well, this is, might actually be a Bishop and Knight mate that we're looking at. We might see somehow the light side might manage to exchange their pieces for the pawns, leaving only a bishop and knight. Unlikely, but maybe possible. Yeah, actually, that Gungan on F4, at least I think that's a Gungan, but yeah, he stops knight to E6. And knight to E6 is protected by the bishop. Wait, what am I missing? Oh, I'm sorry, the Wookiee, which is defended on E6, prevents... I'm not sure what's being prevented anymore. But the way this played out, Luke was forced to move away from the Stormtroopers, and now they promote. Just not what White was looking forward to. So the only question here is, how many Vaders do you promote to before the Rebel Alliance concedes this? There's one Vader. Oh, another check. Yeah, why not check? Oh, I guess Boba's gonna get it. That sucks for Boba. Oh, wait, where are you going? Where are you going? Oh, another check? You sure that's a good idea? Yeah, no, you're out of checks, buddy. Let's promote. Yeah, now we got another Vader. There's no way that could go poorly. Luke takes out some of his anger and aggravation on Boba there. Ooh. Look at that. Non-bloody violence. So I'm curious, just what's the most efficient way to checkmate with two Vaders? It's also kind of funny to see how quickly the dark side gives up its pieces as soon as it's got two Vaders. It has no interest in preserving the life of teammates. Oh, that's checkmate. Well, that's pretty ruthless, gotta say. Peace is restored to the galaxy. Empire prevails. Peace is restored, the rebels are crushed. So, maybe this is just to balance out with the result of the first game. But, yeah, this is a pretty striking final position, not gonna lie. Luke walked right into that one. But, yeah, I think, even as you're pointing out, the opening that was selected bore the seeds of despair that came to fruition throughout the middle game and end game. And, you know, Black just dominated the center, ultimately the C-file, and was able to manage what I thought was an unfavorable bishop exchange that was actually favorable. Because it left Black with a light-squared bishop. And from then on, just this C-file invasion was just crushing. White lost the A-pawn and B-pawn while pushing pretty recklessly on the king's side. And unfortunately for White, there was no perpetual check, so that's the end of that. Yeah. Definitely the best Star Wars chess game ever. And best Star Wars game of all time, too. Yeah, you say what you will about Star Wars Rebellion. Ain't nothing beating the chess game. I don't know, maybe I'll have to try out Rebellion at some point. It's been a while. Anyhow, thanks for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. And hope to see you guys next time. Get ready for some speed reading. Alright, who caught the guy who did the animation? Did anybody see who did the animation? No. I'll have to slow it down sometime. But may the 4th be with you.